Hi, Valerie Mawinney here. I'm going to show you everything you need to know to create process flow diagrams with Miro online whiteboard, like this one, in just 10 minutes. No, 9, just 9. It'll just take us 9 minutes. I've reviewed lots of Miro templates so you don't have to, and this one is the simplest one to get you up and going quickly to create your work process flow. First, you need to create a Miro account. I've left the link below the video, and Miro is free to share with up to 5 users. So once you've created your account, come in here. I already have 2 boards created. You can have 3, up to 3 with a free account. The first thing you need to do is create a new board. It will open this. Just create team board. It will open the template search window. So here, what you do is type in SOP. And SOP stands for Standard Operating Procedure. And this is the template we want. So hover over it and click Use. And Miro will place it on our new board. So let's give it the name, My Grocery Shopping Project. Click away and it's saved. Now, let's clean up this board and get it ready to use. There's 2 important tips to navigate them around the Miro board. First of all, your center wheel on your mouse will zoom in and out, and your right mouse button will drag, and that's the 2 fingers if you're using an Apple trackpad. First thing we're going to do is customize the template. You can see the entire thing is selected. Click away. Let's delete this because it's just wasting space. And the other thing we're going to do, drag and select everything in that legend and delete it. I don't like how it's formatted. We're going to create our own. So first thing you're going to do is open the shapes in the sidebar right here. Yeah, or you could press S, and then we're going to click all shapes. First thing we're going to do is select 5 basic shapes for our own legend. This one, which is the process widget. We'll take the decision box, we'll take the terminator, use the connector, and we'll take the OR symbol. Okay, just click the X, close the sidebar. Next, we're going to delete these sample widgets. It will delete the connectors along with it. And we're starting with a clean template. Next thing we're going to do, if you select the swim lane group, you will see it opens a context menu. Cell resize is set to auto by default. I like to control this myself, so change that to manual. And the next thing we're going to do is add a frame, which allows us to just group everything together and name this frame. You can either click this on the sidebar or press F. It will open this, and I'm just going to set a custom frame. And it is a frame that it creates a white space behind your drawing. I'm going to make it a little bigger there to give a space to grow. And I'm going to name this frame. And so you double click in there, as is grocery shopping workflow. Next, I'm going to show you 5 time-saving Miro shortcuts. First of all, you can select all the widgets at the same time, and that will allow you to move them together or customize them to be all uniform. Select the 4 that have text and you will see a context menu. This will allow you to change the size of the text to be consistent. I liked it at 18. You can make sure they're all bold if you like. You can align them to the center. You can even insert a hyperlink. The other thing you can do is change the text color. I'm going to keep it black. The second tip is when I want to put one of these widgets on my swim lane, all I need to do is hold down the option button and drag it into place, and I get a duplicate copy. I'm going to bring down the decision box as well. The third tip is to create lines. Highlight this, you'll see 4 blue dots. Hover over this dot, drag it to your next widget, and it creates the line for you with an arrow. I'm going to add an OR widget and 2 more process boxes. Connect them with my arrows, I would like to have a different shape or design of arrow. So when you click it, you will see type, open type, and you have several choices, straight arrow, angles, curves, and you also have three, either solid line, dashed, or dots. I like the curve because that makes it easy to see and distinguish. Now this one I'm also going to change to curved. And after that, the arrows that you create will all take the curved shape. This process will go in here, and you see it's taking the curved shape. And the fifth tip is I'm going to change the swim lane size. If I have the swim lane group completely selected and I change the size of it, it also changes the size of my actor box over here. I don't want to do that. Click away to deselect it. Hover over the line and it will just move this line. And if I bring it up here to add another swim lane at the bottom, click the plus arrow. Stay for a few more moments and I'll speed this up and show you my grocery shopping workflow. Miro has so many advantages over Visio and PowerPoint. You can see how easy it is to draw when you know a few simple shortcuts. In my next video, I'll create my vision grocery shopping work process flow. I want AI to do my grocery shopping for me. After all, AI is supposed to take over my job, right? Surely it can do my shopping. I appreciate if you use my affiliate Miro link below to try it for free. Don't forget to press like to encourage the YouTube algorithm. There, that only took 8 minutes, so I'll give you 1 minute back. Best kind of meeting. Thanks for watching.